Hi there, Sirdar Yegulaup here from InfoWorld at IDG. Today I'll be looking at f-strings in Python. This is the feature that lets you format data for printing using string templates. Now f-strings are relatively new. Python added them with version 3.6, so for a while many tutorials didn't discuss them, and only recently have Python packages, including items in the standard library, started using them more often. But at this point, they're the best first choice for how to format data because they elegantly cover the vast majority of use cases. Let's take a look in this first example here of how an f-string works. It's simply a string prefixed with f, and with any variables you want inserted into the string, delineated with curly braces. In this first example, we have two variables, the string name and the date value last sign-on. When we print that string, those two variables are automatically converted to their string representations and inserted into the string at those points. Note that f-strings can only work if the variables referenced in the string are actually in the namespace at that time. The f prefix on the string causes the binding of variables into it to take place right when it's declared. So if you want to create a string beforehand and bind variables into it later, then the older format function will do that for you. And as you can see, the string format used by fstrings is basically the same string format used by the format function. So if you've already been using format, you'll have some idea of how to use fstrings too. Also, as an aside, this situation I've described right here is a good test for whether to use fstrings or format. If you have a string template that you want to define ahead of time and reuse in multiple contexts, use format with a regular string. If you're formatting for output right away, which is the more common scenario, use an f-string. And you can mix them up, too. You can use f-strings to generate strings used for variables in a format function, or vice versa. Now, before f-strings came along, Python had a mini-formatting language that was used to format how things like dates and floating-point numbers were printed. F-strings let us use that formatting, too. In this example, for formatting dates, we can take our date value and print it as a month and a year, by using a colon to separate the name of the variable from its formatting information. The same thing goes for formatting a decimal value in this example. Another convenient feature in f-strings, if you use an exclamation point after the variable, you can then use S, R, or A to obtain the string conversion, the representation, or the ASCII converted representation of an object, respectively. Python 3.8 added an f-string feature that's very useful for debugging. If you place an equal sign after a variable expression in an f-string, the name of the variable and its value are inserted into the string at that point rather than just the value. If you've worked at all with strings, you ought to know by now that you can escape quotes within strings a number of different ways. One common way is to use different quote types for the string definition versus the contents of the string. With f-strings, you have to use different quotes within f-string variable expressions than you do for the string definition itself. In this example, I'm using double quotes for the f-string and single quotes for the inner expression. Another way to get around this is just to create temporary variable bindings and use those instead so you're not fussing with strings inside strings and potentially making more headache for yourself. Another pitfall to watch out for when using a string in an f-string variable expression is backslash escapes. You can't use them inside a string that's in an f-string variable, because otherwise the interpreter has no idea where the escaping is taking place, whether it's in the f-string itself or in the f-string variable reference. If we uncomment this code, our script won't even run now because Python can't parse that line. Again, to get around this, just use a temporary variable binding. It'll probably make your code more readable overall anyway. If you like this video, please leave a comment below. Don't forget to subscribe to the IDG Tech Talk channel on YouTube. And for more Python tips, be sure to follow us on Facebook, YouTube, and InfoWorld.com.